1974, when my father bought our property on Spring Mountain, Zinfandel was simply not on his radar. He was a Bordeaux and Burgundy guy and figured Spring Mountain was going to be Bordeaux territory. So it was all Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, Merlot, and a little bit of Chardonnay, Chateau cash flow Chardonnay. But when I took over in 1998, I wanted to experiment a little and also honor the history of our property. We are one of the ghost wineries of the Napa Valley, which means that they were in business starting in the late 19th century, going out of business sometime during Prohibition, fallow for decades until being purchased by a new owner and then restored. So our original owners were the Conradis from Northern Italy, who arrived, you know, right around, I think, 1890. The official building of the winery is 1904. And then in 1930, they sold the property, changed hands twice, and Dad bought it in 1974. So when I came back to the winery in 98, I thought, well, you know, let's experiment with this bit of history. So planted a small half acre to Zin, began to monkey around with different blends, and then thought, well, why not plant Alicante, Boucher, and Carignan, two of the obscure black varietals from Europe that I think were grown on the property by the Conradis. I do think Zinfandel is a varietal that needs to have additional grapes in it to really make it complete. And I think Alicante and Carignan really fit the bill by adding to the blend without detracting from the subtle nature of Zinfandel. I think most people would be kind of surprised to here that I believe Zinfandel is actually closer in its nature to Pinot Noir than any other varietal we work with, because it's actually a relatively delicate varietal. It's light to medium body, light to medium colored, has a lot of nuance, has herbaceous qualities, does have a distinct sweet sort of brambleberry, sweet raspberry marker in the fruit profile, but is a wonderfully a delicate and nuanced grape when handled properly. So this Not History project is now in its 21st year, I guess. We've got two blocks now planted that are both wonderfully mature, both have the other two varietals in them that we pick simultaneously and co-ferment to make a beautifully nuanced Zinfandel that has, I think, just remarkable food pairing potentials. And I've told this story a few times, but one of my favorite food and wine pairings that I've ever had in my entire career was down in Los Angeles about 4 years ago with a chef who did a beet and beef tartare with the Zinfandel. The beets were cooked and then cubed about a quarter inch, so they really blended seamlessly with the raw beef nodules. And then he put that on a bed of multigrain mustard, plopped that on a multigrain cracker, drizzled it with a pomegranate syrup drizzle, and then sprinkled basil microgreens over it. And then he served the Zinfandel in a Burgundy glass, which I think is the best way to really show off the nuance of this wine. And, you know, our Zinfandel at the time was retailing for, I think, $38. And I just thought, wow, this is one of the best glasses of wine I've ever had in my life with this incredible dish. I mean, it's just blowing up every aspect of the Zin, the herbaceousness, the rich, ripe red fruit, the acidity made it all hum, and the earthy nuance of the mustard. And it was just truly incredible for a $38 bottle of wine. Not from the library. This wine is now 13 years old and is aging beautifully. Still has that bright, you know, red core of rich fruit that has plenty of nuance to go with it. And truly a unique wine. I think only two of us on Spring Mountain are actually making an estate Zin, and the other winery I'm sure most of you have never heard of. So truly unique wine, and really it's prime now. We'll hold for a number of years to go, but it's really ready to be enjoyed right now. So take advantage of this limited library offer, and cheers, you guys.